Mothers this morning, I want to wish them a happy Mother's Day. We have a little special presentation for the mothers in the audience who are of our youth group, and in one case, the mother of our youth group leader.
Thank you. wants you to think and act like Jesus.
God's plan for you is nothing short of who you are.
God wants you to be just like Jesus. He wants you to have a heart like his.
God's love mirrors Jesus.
Our evil cannot diminish his love.
please rise and join with me in the prayer of invocation. O God, as we gather here this morning, let us remember that our truth and our holy ones are sincere. Let us travel together in each other's footsteps and prepare our hearts so that you may travel in ours as well. Give us the courage to follow you in your footsteps today and every day. Amen.
Thank you.
lady came running down the aisle, followed by five tiny balls of fur. One of the puppies died in that. Immediately, the little boy asked about the lady puppy, "What's wrong with that puppy?" The veterinarian told us that the dog was missing a hip socket, said the store owner. "He'll always look like that." That's the one. been ready for years and for the world's foundation. And here's why. I was hungry, and you fed me. I was thirsty, and you gave me a drink. I was homeless, and you gave me a room. I was shivering, and you gave me clothes. I was sick, and you stopped to visit. I was in prison, and you came to me. Then those sheep are going to say, Master, what are you talking about? When did we ever see you hungry and feed you, thirsty and give you a drink? And when did we ever see you sick or in prison and come to you? Then the king will say, in common solemn truth, whenever you did one of these things to someone, overlooked or ignored, that was me. You did it to me.
Before I went on that legal trip, that changed my heart, I was a typical swan of the world.
through the amazing, incredible people that they are. I never saw it before, but the whole trip was a moment that restored my powers and even beyond acceptance. It was a moment that reached into my heart and into my mind. It was a moment that inspired love and understanding. It was a moment that was so perfectly timed with the rhythm of my heart, and a moment when I fell in love. You will never know something until you spend time in their shoes. You will never know something until you can open yourself up to it and make yourself vulnerable. If you put your heart on the line, you put yourself just a little closer to the amazing colors.
Learning. It makes no difference in who they are. In fact, my
Judaism. Judaism is good. And Islam is a beautiful faith, too. I'd like to greet my Muslim friends with a cordial Assalamu alaikum, peace be with you. Then you have Zoroastrianism, the little-known older sibling of those other three. They all worship God.
The girls in the school dorm heard the sound of gunshots from a nearby town, so when armed men in uniforms burst in and promised to rescue them, at first they were relieved. Don't worry, we're soldiers, one 16-year-old girl paused and said, nothing is going to happen to you. Gunmen commanded the hundreds of students at the Chibok Government School, Government Girls Secondary School in Nigeria to gather outside. Families had sent their girls to this rural school in Chibok for a desperately needed education. This northeastern town is part of the Borno region, where 72% of primary children have never attended school. The men went back into the school and into a storeroom where they removed all the food. And then they set the room on fire. They started shouting, Allahu Akbar, God is great, the 16-year-old student said. And we knew. What they knew was chilling. The men were not government soldiers at all. They were members of the ruthless extremist group known as Boko Haram. Boko Haram is a terrorist group whose name literally translates to Western education is a sin. According to accounts, armed members of Boko Haram overwhelmed security guards at this school last month, pulled 300 girls out of bed and forced them into trucks. Then the convoy of trucks disappeared into the dense forest bordering Cameroon. A month later, 276 girls are still missing. At least two have died, and about 20 others are dead, according to an intermediary who was in touch with their captors. I will sell them in the market, stated the leader of Boko Haram, as if they were vegetables, or livestock, or baskets. In these baskets in front of you are the names of 177 of those girls. Their last names are not included for fear of more violence toward their families. There are 99 others held captive whose names we do not know. As you listen to our music, members of our youth group will be handing out these names for you. Please take one, take it with you, and pray for her. Today we join with hundreds of other congregations in praying for these girls, and in doing so, confirm our own church's commitment to the mission to end human trafficking and the selling of our children.
Thank you.
count our blessings. We have so very much. If we are the body of Christ, we need to reach out our hands. Let us now reach out to our church, our community, and our world for that one moment.
She slips in, trying to fade in. situation. It joins you and God and aims you towards the same goal. So many times people are running in the opposite direction, hoping God is going to support their endeavors. You should get God involved in those endeavors before you even move. Never be afraid to yield your will to God. He wants you to succeed. His will is always to your advantage.
Thank you. If I could be you, and you could be me, for just 1 hour. If you could find a way, you could die. Thank you.